This is Jeffrey Drazen for the New England Journal of Medicine. Exposure to air pollution is associated with increased rates of asthma, ischemic heart disease, and even death. To protect the health of the population, the United States Environmental Protection Agency sets National Ambient Air Quality Standards, or NAAQS, for air pollutants such as fine particulate matter, which we call PM2.5, and ozone. But are current standards stringent enough? Investigators analyzed a cohort of over 60 million Medicare beneficiaries from 2000 to 2012 and linked all-cause mortality data to annual averages of PM2.5 and ozone at the zip code level. With over 460 million person-years of follow-up, and after controlling for demographics, Medicaid eligibility, and area-level covariates, they found that each increase in PM2.5 of 10 micrograms per cubic meter was associated with a 7.3% increase in all-cause mortality, and each increase in ozone of 10 parts per billion was associated with a 1.1% increase in all-cause mortality. When the analysis was restricted to exposures below current NAAQS standards, the same increases in PM2.5 and ozone were associated with a 13.6 and 1.0% increase in mortality, respectively. Males, blacks, and people with Medicaid eligibility had an increased risk of death. The authors conclude that there's evidence of adverse effects of PM2.5 and ozone exposures at concentrations even below current national standards. Full study results are available at NEJM.org.